Hi there, welcome back to my channel. My name is Rutka and this channel is all about AWS cloud, networking and tech. So if you are interested in them, stay tuned for it. In this channel, I will be sharing my experience and my journey with you all guys. So in this video, we will be discussing about AWS EC2, Elastic Compute Cloud. But wait, if you are new to the AWS, you must be thinking, what is EC2? Amazon EC2 is a web service provided by AWS that provides the resizable compute capacity in the cloud. EC2 allows you to run virtual servers on AWS cloud infrastructure called as instance. This word instance you will be listening in whole video. So, these instances can be used for the wide range of computing tasks like hosting a web application on EC2, and you are just paying for what you use. Such a good thing, like you are just paying for what you use. And I've seen the servers stand in the rack and you need to maintain it all the time, and the capacity is not utilized fully, but still you have to maintain those servers as they are on-prem and you have to do all those things. So the best part is that those physical servers are now managed by AWS and you don't need to think about it as how many servers you need to purchase or what the capacity will be and nothing like that. And my organization is also like slowly and steadily moving towards AWS and cloud, and that's why I am doing it because it's the need of the industry. So now, what are the key features of EC2? Scalability, variety of instance type, operating system flexibility, instance storage, security, load balancing, auto scaling, cost control, global reach. What is scalability? In EC2, you can easily scale up and down the capacity of the instance based on your application requirement. So this means you can multiply instances according to your workload. If it increases, you can increase the instances, and once it's done, you can terminate your instances. What do you mean by variety of instance type? It means in EC2, we have a wide range of instance types to optimize various use cases. These instance types differ in terms of like CPU utilization, your memory, your storage, and networking capabilities, allowing you to choose most suitable configuration of your workloads. And we have operating system flexibility in this. You can choose variety of operating system according to your need, like Amazon Linux, Ubuntu, Windows, and more to run on EC2 instances. Instance storage, as EC2 provides various storage options like EBS, Elastic Block Store, and EBS provides persistent and scalable storage option that you can attach to your instances. And for the security, EC2 instances can be launched on VPC, allowing you to control your network access and security groups. And you can also use your Identity Access Management, IAM, for EC2 resources. EC2 instances can be used in conjunction with Elastic Load Balancing, ELB, to distribute incoming traffic across multiple instances, improving the application availability and fault tolerance. I have already told about the auto-scaling, like it will automatically adjust your EC2 instances according to your workload, and you will be paying only what you have used. There are several pricing options in EC2, like on-demand instances, spot instances, and reserve instances. So whatever you need according to your workload, it will be priced. So this will help you to choose cost pricing model according to your work. And global reach. EC2 is available in multiple AWS regions around the world, making it possible to deploy the instances closer to your end users for improved latency and performance. So these are the key features of AWS EC2. If you have any questions regarding this topic, put that on the comments below and let me know. I'll definitely try to answer you or make it another video for you guys to explain it more in detail. So guys, yeah, let's move on with the demo. I will be showing you how to create an EC2 instance on AWS cloud. Yeah guys, so first we will open the AWS console. We'll go to aws.amazon.com and then sign in. It will ask for root user and IAM user. First, we will create the root user. I have already mine. You guys, first you need to sign up for your account. If you want that in detail, let me know. You will be needing your credit card for that, as it will be asking you your card details on the opening of the account. And the thing is, you can open a free account with the Amazon AWS, and but you need to put your card details on it. So remember that. AWS console, management console. And here, click on the services, you can see the various services offered by AWS. We have to go on EC2. It's in under the compute. You can see when you click on compute, you can see here we have AWS Acronor, Batch, EC2, EC2 Image Builder, Elastic Beanstalk, Lambda, LightSail, AWS Outpost, several serverless, application repository, AWS Sims, SimSpace, Viewer. So we'll go on EC2. Click on EC2 and click on Launch Instance. So this is our instance page. Options we need to fill on. We need to give the name for our instance. So we say as EC2. And I will be link. So here we have applications and voice images. Whichever you want to open your EC2 in, you can select your OS image over here. Amazon Linux, macOS, Ubuntu, Windows, Red Hat. So currently I'm on Amazon Linux 2023 AMI, and as you can see here, free tier eligible. So I will be moving on with that as a default. And architecture 64 bits. Instance type. Now which type we need? As we can see on the drop down menu, we have so many here, as you can see. T2 Nano, T2 Micro, T2 Small, Medium, Large, Extra Large, T3 Nano, Micro, Small, Extra Large, and these all according to your workload. As you can see here, 8 CPUs and 32 gig memory. So currently, as you can see, T2 Micro is free tier eligible as you called. Keep your login. This key pair login is basically used for SSH, so you will be needing it. So you need to create a new key pair, rsa.pem, give a name to it, my EC2 key. I'll put that and I'll create. So what it will do, it will create and it will download in your computer for your save, and because you need to keep this key pair for your future use. So you will have this once, so you cannot create it again, so you need to keep it in safe, not lose it. Then we have network settings over here. We have VPC selected, VPC for our network, and okay, auto assigned public IP is enabled, firewall security group. Can create security group, or you can use your existing security group if you have any. Leave it as default, leave it all the things as default. Configure storage, you can have your storage. I'm leaving it default. We have advanced details here. You can put purchasing options and all. We can leave. I will not go through it. Details and everything, just leave it as default. And we can hit on launch instance. So as you can see, it's launching my instance and it will show as success. So once it's done, we can view our instance and click on view all instances. And you can see here, currently the instance state is pending, so it is creating in the backend. So we need to refresh it again. So now it's running. We can click on our instance and you can see we have all the instances. Have this instance here, you can have your IPv4 address from here, and we have public IP and we have private IP, and we have here our DNS. This is how you create your instance on EC2. We can now terminate it. We can go on instance state and we can here. So here, instance terminate, we can it says instance disable termination. Terminate and see successfully terminated and it will get shut down. Yeah guys, so this is how we create our instance on EC2 on AWS cloud. If you have any questions, please put that on the comments below and let me know, as this is just a tip. AWS is so vast, I have just given you a grain of it. If you have enjoyed my video and want to continue with the cloud computing adventure, hit subscribe to my channel, put the like button and click on the bell icon for more videos. And guys, if you have any specific questions on AWS topic and you want me to cover that in my future videos, please put that on the comments below. I'll definitely read those and try to incorporate in my future videos. My goal is to just share with my knowledge with you guys, and I want you all to be in my journey, as this is both way learning. I'm also learning, you also learning. And if you are pro in AWS, explore something new, as every day is a new learning. And guys, if you're still here with me, means you have been supporting me for this. I love you guys and thank you for your support and engagement. Until next time, keep innovating, keep learning and keep building with amazing AWS. This is Ritka Verma signing off. Catch you in next video.